Simon says subscribe and click on the bell icon to receive notifications.
In this lesson, we are going to talk about the parametric filters. This is a very new feature within Photoshop, so new that you can only find it in the beta version. If you do not have the beta version, you need to go to the Creative Cloud desktop application and download it from there. So if you are in that application, you're going to see here, go to apps, go to beta apps, and you'll see it there waiting for you. Make sure that you download it. Make sure you have the most up-to-date version. And you're going to see that it's mostly the same. You're going to see some new additions are added to it. But for the most part, you're going to see that it's the parametric filters that we're going to be playing around with the most. So let's just see how we can use these. Pretty extraordinary and way more than meets the eye. So where do we find all of our parametric filters? We're going to go over here to Filter. And you're going to see here is parametric filters right there. Now this is going to open up on the right hand side, and we've got at least 20 of these things, and they're growing and growing as we speak. And this is pretty awesome. And also notice that if you want to give them feedback, since this is a beta version, you can always give them feedback. So let's go ahead and just put on one of these here. So if we look at these, you're going to see here black and white, color, distortion, glass filter, and oil paintings, and some of the symmetry, scratch. You can see there's a lot you can play around with, but there's so much more than meets the eye. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to simply click on this oil painting one. And as a result, you're going to notice right away it's going to change. And you'll also notice in the Layers panel, it automatically creates a smart filter. Well, what does that mean when something is a smart filter? It means it's non-destructive. And I've got this little mask icon right there, my little thumbnail. It's going to allow me to then adjust how much of that filter I've applied to it. And again, it is non-destructive, so I always have the original to go back to if I like. All right, now you'll also notice that there is a new panel that appears here called Parametric Properties. And it's for this particular filter that I've just created, the oil paint filter. Now, there is a lot going on here. You can see properties, presets, you can randomize, basically saying, hey, you know what, just give me something, I'm gonna roll the dice. And you have all kinds of different things about intensity, detail, which direction your strokes are gonna go in, all kinds of good stuff here. Now, why am I showing you this? Because every time you apply a parametric filter, you're going to see all kinds of different options and properties that you can manipulate. All right, now this one's pretty good as it is, but let's just see what happens if I play around with, let's just say, one of these presets. Click on my little drop down here, and you're gonna see, you know what, let's just try Sketch. No idea what this is gonna do. And you can see on the bottom, it is telling me it's updating, it's doing some magic, it might take some time. So just wait for it to update. And you're going to see some things are going to change. And you can say, okay, right, do I like that? Do I not like that? Eh, not so much. Let's go ahead and undo that. But at some point, you may want that. All right, so other presets you might want to explore, just go ahead and check those out. Now, let's go back again to my properties, and let's just try a different one. Let's go ahead and just try the fine details. So I'm just going to go ahead and just drag this up a little bit. And again, it's going to take a few beats for it to update. And again, this is very much a spice to taste type of thing, and it's not so bad. Okay, so I like that. We're on our way. And just note here that on the bottom, you might have some other options under Transform that you might want to explore, checking out the scale, right? How much is going to kind of just expand itself over the original. Again, it's very much spice to taste, and you're going to like what you see when you like it. And then again, you can always add on your preset that you like. All right, now what we're going to do next is take advantage of this mask, because part of this, you know what, I actually really do want to see this a little more clarity, kind of like this, but you know what, maybe not so much, not so intense. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to work with my mask here to make it so I'm going to see some of that original come through, all right, and maybe even the table a little bit. I don't want it to be all kind of like blown out of proportion like that. But overall, I'm pretty happy with it. But let's just go ahead and see what we can do with our mask. So I click on this, my mask right here, my thumbnail. And then very simply, I'm going to go over here to my brush tool, and I'm going to go over here again to my black and white, making sure that we have black in the foreground. If yours is not showing up, you can set it to the default by simply clicking here, and then you can toggle back and forth. Now, I'm going to make it so my opacity for my brush, you can see here's my opacity, is not at 100%. I'm just going to bring this down to maybe like 50%. because I don't want to make it so the original shows through, because I want to have kind of a half and half version of the original and also this lovely oil painting. So very simply, I'm just going to just click and drag over that, and you can see a little bit of it comes through, so I'm able to control how much of it is oil and how much of it is reality. Let's bring that back a tiny, tiny bit. Okay, all right, cool. Get a little bit of texture there. And guess what? If I change my mind, I like it again, I can always reverse this back to white and then bring it back just where it was before, and then potentially even bringing up my opacity again to make it so it's all the way up to 100 and then bringing it back entirely. You can see, all right, great. You know what? Changed my mind back to the original. I really like that. So very, very cool. All right, now let's go ahead and take a look at maybe a handful more, and we're gonna see what other ways we can work with these new filters. Let's come over here to this image, and let's see some other options what we have available. So I'm gonna go back over here to Filter, Parametric Filters, and let's just try something totally different. I'm gonna go over here to the Spherify, and then just wait for it, and it's gonna completely warp it. Kind of a neat feature for when we're working with a mirror. Okay, not so bad. And then you'll notice again, there are some presets. You can play around with those if you like. Scroll down a little bit more. Let's check out the size. Let's go to make it go a little bit bigger this time, see what it does. Again, watching the update, so we're patient. We know what's happening there. So we don't get too impatient. We understand it's doing something pretty remarkable. All right, so that's pretty cool. I like that. Now, let's see what we can do in terms of stacking some of these. So what I'm going to do now is go back over to my filter and then go to Parametric Filters. And this time I want to add on this kind of cool one here, maybe kind of cruel more than cool, as I'm going to use this little scratch one. So if I want to add on a stack to it, I have to actually add on a keyboard modifier in order to do that. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hold down the Alt key or Option key if you're on a Mac and just simply click on it. And then just wait for it. Doesn't seem like a whole lot's happening, but then you're going to see one more filter appear right on top of that other filter. Now they don't name them, so we just have to understand what we're working with here. As we're working with these individual ones, they stack on top. Now, if I want to kind of adjust this somewhat and kind of play with a little bit more, I can go inside of this little filter effect right here. I'm going to double click on this little kind of equalizer button. And while that's loading up, just remember you have all kinds of different options to change burnt, scratches, damages, because this is a completely different filter. You'll play around with that one to see the kind of effect you want to get. All right, so I'm just going to bring down the opacity a little bit for this one. So you can see it gives me a nice little preview. So maybe it's not so bad, okay? But it's kind of the effect that I want. And then I could even play around with some of these blending modes, right? So let's just do something very, very different. Let's go over here to exclusion, and you can see, okay, that's kind of interesting. Let's try here to difference, okay? Oh, that's kind of interesting too. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and just maybe bring down my opacity just a little bit more. So just keeping my texture, click okay. And now I've got something very unique. And if I wanted to make it even more interesting, yes, I would play around with all the other different effects that have to do with this particular filter. Let's just do one more. And notice that there's another one called Parametric 3.jpg that I have in here that looks just like that first one. But I'm using this one just to show you one of the other filters that I think this could really serve you well on. But you certainly want to experiment with it. So let's go ahead and bring this up again. And we're going to go to my Parametric Filters. And this time we're going to do this one Symmetry Filter. And this one's pretty extraordinary because it definitely requires a lot of experimentation. But in order to create something like this, it would take a lot of work. But you also get something pretty neat looking. So just right off the bat, all I'm going to do is simply click on Symmetry, and then we're going to wait for it to run, do its magic, and just like that, we're going to get something pretty cool. Right? And you're going to see that it creates this kind of like mandala kind of effect, and we're of course going to have all kinds of different control on this, but it's completely unrecognizable, which is so cool. So you're going to see here that there are some presets you can experiment with, and you can see there's all kinds of different ones. Right? You'll see that it's pretty awesome. You'll just, again, spice the taste with all of these. And then you're going to see down if I come down to below, and if I want to make this go even more so, I'll just go up maybe up to 10. Wait for it. And you'll notice now I've got more of my little spikes there. Pretty cool. Let's come down a little bit more. I'm just going to bring up my horizontal shift a tiny bit, and we'll see what that's going to do. You're going to see, just wait for it, and you'll see that it completely transforms it, right? Really, really extraordinary. Again, this is really kind of a spice to taste things because there's no way for us to really predict what we're going to get. So let's just bring down my vertical shift this time, see what that does, and then wait for it. And you'll begin to learn what these things do as you keep playing with it and playing with it, right? But notice, when I bring down my vertical shift, it brings it in. It kind of sucks in a little bit, which I really don't want. So I'm going to bring that back to this. And if I wanted to kind of spike out even further outside the canvas, that's what it's going to do even more and more and more. All right, and let's just bring this out a little bit, a little bit, a little bit. See what that's going to do. And you see, dramatically different. Okay, so again, this is very much spice to taste. Not a big fan. The first one was probably my favorite, and maybe the second one after that, but it is awesome. So just kind of throw a bunch of random images in there. Maybe you're making a collage for somebody. Could be kind of fun with some faces in there, albeit maybe a little bit creepy after a while. And then possibly you want to combine it with another one of those filters, and then another one and another one to be able to get something really creative.
If you're not a subscriber, click down below to subscribe so you get notified about similar videos we upload. To see the full course that this video came from, click over there. And click over there to see more videos from Simon Says It.